Hallelujah. What manner of man is Jesus? What manner of man is Jesus? Hallelujah. He made the blind to see. Hallelujah. He made the lame to walk. Hallelujah. What manner of man is Jesus? Oh, sing hallelujah, 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 amen, hallelujah, hallelujah, amen. Issues of this. And so that you are, and so that you are, you will never change. Ancient of days, and so that you are, and so that you are. You will never change. Your banner over us. Your banner over us. Your banner over us. Is Lord Jesus, Alpha and Omega, my Redeemer. The I am that I am, your banner over us. Your banner over us. Your banner over us is Lord. Who can love us the way you do, Jesus? Who can love us the way you do? Who can love us the way you do? Who can love us the way you do? No one, no one. Who can love me the way you do? Who can love me the way you do? Who can love me the way you do? No one. Who can love us? Who can love us the way you do? Alpha and Omega. Who can love us the way you do? Who can love us the way you do? No one, no one. Who can love us the way you do? Who can love us the way you do? Who can love us the way you do? No one. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. God bless us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
You are all welcome in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
You are welcome to Rhema Deliverance Night Vigil. God bless us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So we just call on I don't know if Sister Joy is there. Okay.
No, she's not.
Okay. Sister Cynthia. Hello, Sister Cynthia.
Hallelujah. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Okay. Sister, I will just do the opening prayer.
Okay,
I'll just do the opening prayer before you do the announcements. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord of Lords and the King of Kings. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen. We are all welcome here tonight. We are going to go before the Lord God Almighty and begin to thank the Lord for this wonderful day that he has given us. Let us begin to thank the Lord. I would like us to open our mics, unmute our mics, and begin to thank the Lord God Almighty for his mercy upon our lives, for his grace upon our lives. There are many in the mortuary right now. They did not know they would be there today. There are many who are in the hospital. Accident upon accident. Many things have happened to people today, but you and I are here today. We are here in the presence of the Lord God Almighty. And the Bible says that only the living can praise the Lord. So we are here to praise him. We are here to thank him for his goodness. We praise the Lord. We worship him. Begin to worship him for his goodness in your life. Begin to exalt his holy name. Begin to thank him for what he has done, for keeping you, for sustaining you, for sustaining your family, for sustaining your children, for sustaining your husband and your wife, anybody, your family members. Let us begin. Amen. Amen. Brethren, at this time, we are going to continue We are going to ask the Lord for mercy. Let us ask him for mercy in any way that we are falling short of his glory. For because the Bible makes us to understand that if we say we have not sinned, then we make God to be a liar and the truth is not in us. We are not making God to be a liar today. He will never lie. He's the God of truth. He's the God of kindness and mercy. And so let us go before him tonight. He is faithful and just to forgive us of our sins, brethren. So let us open our mouth, confess our sins before the Lord, ask for mercy, plead on the behalf of our loved ones, plead on the behalf of the members of REM, plead on the behalf of anyone you know, your neighbors, people in your village, people in your town, where you know they're committing idol worship, where you know that there is so much fornication going on. Begin to plead for mercy, for the Lord God Almighty, the mercy of the Lord to rain down upon us tonight in the mighty name of Jesus. Prayer. Father, Lord God Almighty, Lord Jehovah, we come before you. We ask for mercy, oh God. Brethren, I cannot hear you. Let us submit our minds and begin to plead for mercy.
Abba, Father, Lord, and my God, Lord Jesus,
I ask for your mercy. Let us submit our minds right now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, King of kings and Lord of lords. Father, Lord, we have come before you. We have come before your throne of God. Obtain mercy in God at this very hour, God Jehovah. Mercy upon our lives, oh God. Father, in any way, Lord, that we have fallen short of your glory.
My Father, the thoughts of my heart, Lord, my God, the words of my mouth, Lord, my Lord, have mercy upon me, Lord Jesus. Have mercy upon me, Lord Jesus. Father, Father, let your mercy be upon us.
Brethren, at this time, we are going to go before the, we are going to ask the Lord, we are going to ask him to release the blood of Jesus over us. Let the blood of Jesus begin to cover this whole atmosphere. Let the blood of Jesus begin to cover this environment. Let the blood of Jesus soak us in and out, body, soul, and spirit. Where we are, in that room where you are right now, let the blood of Jesus begin to soak all the furniture, the ceiling, the roof, the floor, the doors, the windows, everything. Soak your car in the blood of Jesus. Soak our loved ones in the blood of Jesus. Soak this ministry in the blood of Jesus. Soak the network, every gadget we are going to be using here tonight, in the blood of Jesus. Brethren, begin to plead for the blood of Jesus to cover us right now. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, the Lord of kings and Lord of lords, we come before you, Lord. That blood that was shed on the cross of Calvary, that blood that is written in the book of Lord, the blood of Jesus over my family, that blood of God Jehovah, that is written in the blood of Jesus over my family, that blood of God over the blood of Jesus over my family, well, Lord, my Father, I see the blood of Jesus over the furniture, over the roof, over my Father, over the door, over the window, over the
soul, body, and spirit.
Father, let the blood of Jesus begin to flow like that in the name of Jesus. My Lord, my God, I cover my husband, whatever I eat, in the blood of Jesus, Lord. I cover his calendar in the blood of Jesus, Lord. I cover his son with the blood of Jesus, Lord.
Let that blood cover us right now.
I cover my mother in the blood of Jesus, Lord. I cover my wife in the blood of Jesus, Lord. I cover my business in the blood of Jesus, Lord. I cover my son in the blood of Jesus, Lord. My Father, Lord, my God. My son, my mother, my new home, my father, my surrounding, my home, my surrounding, my father, my husband, my property, my house, my blood, 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 my bl
blood of Jesus. I speak to the blood of Jesus. Over my mother, through the blood of Jesus, over her house, through the blood of Jesus, over her work, over her husband, whoever, the blood of Jesus, over my husband, over his job, my mother, my father, Lord, after the blood of Jesus, over his body, Lord, after the blood of Jesus, over his talent, after the blood of Jesus, Father, let your blood of God be Jesus, also in the name of Jesus, Father, Lord, my God, in the name of Jesus, after the blood 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 of Jesus, over my life, Father, over my over my house, over my family, in the name of Jesus, over my surrounding.
Jesus, mighty name, we are praying. Amen, brethren. We are going to ask now. For the Spirit, can we mute where that noise is coming from? Praise the Lord. Can the host mute that noise? Thank you so much, beloved. God bless you. Okay, at this hour, we are going to invite the presence of the sweet Holy Spirit, the gentle Holy Spirit. He must be invited to come. He leaves whenever there is something that does not please the Father, whenever there is something that does not please the Lord Jesus. We have asked for forgiveness, and we know that the Lord has forgiven us. So we can invite the Holy Spirit now to come and to take absolute control. Let the Holy Spirit come and take charge of this atmosphere, take charge of this meeting, take charge of the coordinators, the leaders, the whoever is going to lead us in any prayer, in any segment. Let the Lord God Almighty, Holy Spirit, begin to take control of them right now. Let every flesh begin to die in this place. Let nobody speak of their own volition, but of the will of the Father, as the Holy Spirit gives utterance in the mighty name of Jesus. Brother, open your mouth and begin to invite the Holy Spirit to come and take control of this meeting, take control of this deliverance night in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, Lord God Almighty, let us unmute our mic and begin to pray. Let us unmute our mic.
Come and have your will, Lord Jesus. Father, we invite your presence, Lord. Father, we acknowledge your presence, Holy Spirit. Father, come and have your will, Lord Jesus. Have your will, Lord, in our midst, O God. Have your will, Lord, in our midst, O God. Father, come and take absolute control, Lord. Absolute control of our prayer, Lord. Father, come and direct us, O God, my Father. In the name of Jesus Christ, Father, come and take control over our homes, Lord, my Father. Over this environment, Lord, my Father. Father, let the power of the Holy Spirit, Lord, my Father, descend upon us, Lord, my Father. Father, we pray for your presence, Lord. Holy Spirit of God, come and take control. Holy Spirit of God, come and take control. Holy Spirit of God, come and take control. Father, Lord, that my God, let everything known by the of you in our life be pushed out by the blood of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. Father, Lord, that my God, anything that's out of you in our life, let it be written out in the name of Jesus Christ. My Father, Lord, that my God, Holy Spirit of God, come and have your way. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. Father, come and take control. In the name of Jesus Christ. Father, come and take control. In the name of Jesus Christ. Holy Spirit of God, come and have your way. Father, we welcome you. We welcome your presence, Lord, my Father. Father, we welcome your presence, Lord. Father, we need you, Lord Jesus. Holy Spirit of God, come and have your way. Incubate our life to God with your power. Incubate our life to God with your fire. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus Christ. Father, Lord, I'm going to come and take control. In Jesus' name.
Praise, O Lord God Almighty. Father, let your presence reign in our midst today, O God. Let your presence reign over the airwaves today, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ. Take absolute control. Have your way, Lord, that you have your way. For in Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Brethren, we are going to pray one more prayer. We are going to pray. We're going to ask the Lord God Almighty to quicken the footsteps of the members that are supposed to be here. Those that he has a divine appointment with tonight in this meeting, that are not here, that the Lord will quicken their footsteps, that the Holy Spirit will go and wake them up. Those that are still sleeping, I understand it is 1 a.m. in some parts of the world, in some places it's 2 a.m. And we know that they are maybe in the spirit of slumber may have come and taken over them. Let the Holy Spirit wake them up for this divine appointment in the name of Jesus. Tonight is deliverance night. Somebody is going to be delivered tonight. Let them not miss their deliverance in the name of Jesus. Let us begin to pray for the brethren that are still on their way coming right now, that the Lord God Almighty will quicken their footsteps, bring them here in the name of Jesus Christ. Prayer.
In the name of our Lord and Savior, Father,
in the mighty God, in the name of Jesus,
King of kings, Lord, King of kings, Lord, 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 everybody that is supporting me here, my Father, Lord, and my God, Father, keeping them over, my Father, oh Jesus, keeping them over, Lord, keeping them over, before Jesus Christ, in the name of Jesus, Father, Lord, and my God, keeping them over, my Father, Father, wake them up from every slumber, wake them up, Holy Spirit of God, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus Christ, Father, Lord, and my God, begin to move to them wherever they are, Father, Lord, just move them up to the Lord, let their body be taken over, my Father. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, Father, Lord, and my God, Father, we pray, oh God, that you bring them here right now. In the name of Jesus, Christ. Have your will, Lord Jesus, have your will, Lord Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Brethren, we are going to now obtain power. Because the Bible makes us to understand that we are seated in heavenly places with Christ Jesus, and that he has given all authority in heaven and on earth to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. So, which means that if we are seated in heavenly places with Christ Jesus, we also have authority that the Lord has given unto us, delegated authority. Let us begin to use that authority right now to destroy every work of darkness over this environment, over this meeting, wherever they are gathered. They are not gathered. Surely they shall gather, but not by the Lord, and they shall be scattered in the mighty name of Jesus. Begin to use your authority to scatter them right now. Wherever they are gathered over, let the Holy Ghost fire go and scatter them in the name of Jesus. My Father, Lord, my God,
every object, agenda, every plan, every manipulation of the powers of darkness, against this meeting, against us, against our family members. My Lord, my God, in the name of Jesus Christ, in the name of Jesus Christ, wherever they are gathering, my Father, we release the thunder of the Holy Ghost, every power, Lord, my Father, who's been over us, my Lord, my God, we release the fire of the Holy Ghost, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus Christ, Father, Lord, my God, every arrow of darkness, O Lord, fire that gets on us, we command the arrow not to catch fire right now, in the name of Jesus Christ, we command it to scatter by thunder, in the name of Jesus Christ, we command it to scatter by fire, we command it to scatter by fire. We command it to be set on fire. Arrows of fire, set on fire. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus Christ, my Lord and my Father, wherever they are risen, my Father, Lord and my God, we pour the blood of Jesus upon the blood of God. Wherever they are gathered, we pour the blood of Jesus Christ. He told them, Father, we release the blood of Jesus Christ. We release the blood of Jesus Christ. We release the blood of Jesus Christ. Wherever they have gathered, are they gathered in the air? Are they gathered in the sea? On the land, my Father, we release the blood of Jesus. We release the blood of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, my Father, Lord and my God, give the angels. Touch over us, O Lord. Let your angel begin to take charge, O Lord, over this environment, over our family members, O Lord, my Father, over this calamity. Angels of God, take charge. Angels of God, take charge. Angels of God, take charge. In the name of Jesus Christ, every work of witchcraft powers, my Father, Lord, and my God, we release the fire of the Holy Ghost wherever they are. We calling upon our name, upon the name of our children, upon the name of every member of them. O Lord, my Father, calling upon the name of our Lord, my Father, we release the thunder of the Holy Ghost.
Jesus Christ, sir. Everlasting Father, thank you, Lord. We give you all the praise and the glory. Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Heavenly Father, I am that I am, Holy One. Yes. Lord God Almighty, we thank you, Father, for tonight. We thank you for all the things that you have planned for us tonight, Father, in the name of Jesus. Father, we will receive our blessings, we will receive our deliverance, we will receive all that you have purposed for our lives tonight in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, Lord, we thank you, oh God Almighty, for your presence. Holy Spirit, thank you for being with us here tonight, oh Lord. Father, our helper, our healer, our advocate, come and help us. Come and speak through us. Come and teach us. Come, oh God, and pray. Because the Bible makes us understand that we do not know what to pray for. But the Holy Spirit gives us utterance, O God Almighty, to pray according to the will of the Father in the name of Jesus Christ. Holy Spirit, come and help us not to pray amiss. Holy Spirit, come and help us, O God, Jehovah. We worship and adore you. We give you all the praise in the mighty name of Jesus. We cover this place in the blood of Jesus. We cover our lives in the blood of Jesus. The atmosphere, the network, the gadgets, the speakers tonight, the man or woman of God that is going to coordinate, that's going to bring the message, that's going to lead the prayer tonight. We cover them all in the blood of Jesus. All the members, we cover the blood of our viewers, Father, Lord God, the blood of Jesus, the blood of Jesus. Our loved ones, Father, the blood of Jesus, in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, Lord God Almighty, have your way in our midst, in the name of Jesus. We open this meeting in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. For in Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Amen. Over to you. Coordinator, over to you, Mr. Mori. Can we have the announcements, please? Let us mute our mic. Praise the Lord. Yes. Hallelujah. Amen. Over to you, Sister Maureen. God bless you, ma. I cannot hear you.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Are you hearing me now?
Yes, we can hear you now. A little better. Please, can you come closer to the mic? Volume.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Okay. Rapture Ready End Time Movement is a heavily mandated ministry instituted by the Lord Jesus Christ through a great burden to win souls for the kingdom of God by populating heaven and depopulating hell. The movement is set to prepare the church for the rapture of the saints and a last day revival of souls. The ministry is a part of the vision of Anne-Elie Chedozie with divine encounters of heaven and hell and the kingdom of darkness, having a youth body to set the heart on fire for Jesus. The ministry hopes to stay the hungers of billions of souls all over the world to love Jesus with all their hearts through a strong discipleship training, revelational knowledge, the word of God, last day revival, and many more. The movement tends to reach out to souls all over the world through undiluted holiness and to let people see the power of the Holy Ghost as the Lord confirms his word with signs and wonders. Our goals are to set the earth on fire through a last day revival to make disciples of all race. Getting souls rapture ready and prepared for heaven, delivering many from the yoke of bondage and sin, exercising the fullness and operation of a fivefold ministry, organizing deliverance, campaign program, and prayers all over the nation. Our vision are salvation, sanctification, undiluted holiness, Holy Ghost baptism, consecration, discipleship, power, fruit and gift of the Holy Spirit. Rain believes in the rapture, tribulation, deliverance, grace, water baptism, Trinity, Holy and spiritual gift, and the totality of the Word of God. Country fellowship. Do well to join our country fellowship in South Africa, Ghana, Germany, Europe, USA, Canada, United Kingdom and spreading across soonness. Weekly activities. Monday, we now have every first Monday and the last Monday of the month is our midnight deliverance program. Start by 1 a.m. On Wednesday, Bible study, 7 p.m. Thursday, Charismatic Fire. Friday, Holy Ghost Power Vigil, 1 a.m. Saturday, Children Fellowship, 4 p.m. Sunday, 12 p.m. Discipleship. Sunday, Fire Service, 1 p.m. Sisters and Brothers, Sunday Fellowship, 5 p.m. Holy Communion Service, last Sunday of the month after service. Morning Devotions, 5 a.m. Country Time, USA / Canada, Germany, Africa / Europe. The ministry gives in its tithe and offering through the ministry account to support the expansion of God's work and the heavenly mandate. Let's be faithful in our tithing and offering and seed sowing to avoid the devourer and closed doors. Let's also support our ongoing deliverance camp project for deliverance in Lagos, Nigeria. For more information, counseling, and more, contact the man of God. God bless you all in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So we call on our sister for choir ministration, for song ministration. Sister Sandra. Sister Sandra.
Hello. Hello.
Hello. Please, can you lead the choir song ministration? God bless you, ma.
Let me try. I'm waking up for sleep. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. More grace, sister. More grace.
Amen.
Amen.
I am the Lord, thy landing. I am the Lord, your healer. I say it's my word. And I heal your disease. I am the Lord, your healer. You are the Lord that led me. You are the Lord, my healer. You set your word, and you healed my disease. You are the Lord, my healer. You set your word, how you healed my disease. You are the Lord, my healer. You set your word, and you heal my disease. You are the Lord, my healer.
You are the Lord. I led me. You are the Lord. My You set your word. Are you healed my disease? You are the Lord, my healer. You set your word. Are you healed my disease? You are the Lord, my healer. You set your word. Are you healed my disease? You are the Lord. My Jesus, you are the Lord. I led me. You are the Lord. My You set your word. Had you healed my disease? You are the Lord, my healer. You set your word. Had you healed my disease? You are the Lord, my healer. You set your word. Had you healed my disease? You are my healer. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. God bless you, Father. Thank you very much for that wonderful ministration. We call our brother. Brother Godwin, to lead us in prayer. God bless you, sir. Brother Godwin. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
It's like Brother Godwin is not there. Okay.
Okay, I think it's network. His network just dropped him. We are going to call on Brother Sunday.
Okay. Brother Sunday, God bless you, sir. Please lead us in prayer.
God bless you, ma'am. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Yes, you are the Lord Most High. Yes, you are the Lord. You are the Lord Most High. Yes, You are the Lord. Most high. Yes, you are the Lord. Most high. Yes, you are the Lord. You are the Lord. Most high. Yes, you are the Lord. Yes, you are the Lord. Most high. Yahweh. Your name is Yahweh. You are the miracle of me. Oh, your name is Yahweh. Yahweh, Yahweh, Yahweh. Your name is Yahweh. You are the miracle working God. Your name is Yahweh, Yahweh, Yahweh. Your name is
Yahweh.
You are the miracle working God. Your name is Yahweh. The Lord is good. Brethren, right now, let's begin to thank God for his mercies, for his goodness, for his kindness. Let's begin to thank him, O Lord, for his name is Yahweh. He's a God who never sleeps nor slumber. He's a mighty God. He's a God who standeth forever. He's a God himself. Let's begin to worship Majesty, let's begin to
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Brother, right now, this moment, let's begin to invite the Holy Spirit in our midst and also welcome him, because he said where one or two are gathered is there in his name, there in their midst. Right now, let's begin to welcome him. Welcome the Holy Spirit to take preeminence, to take control, to take lead, to be the master of this day in the name of Jesus Christ. Prayer.
Abba, Father, Lord, and our God, in the name of Jesus, Holy Spirit of the Most High God, we welcome you, blessed Holy Spirit. Father, we acknowledge your presence in our midst, O God. Abba, Father, Lord, we welcome you, Lord Jesus. We welcome you, Lord Jesus.
In Jesus' precious name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Brother, right now, we are going to pray. We are going to ask God that for God to have mercies on us, forgive us of anything that will stand against our blessings today, against our deliverance, against our testimony tonight. Let's ask God to begin to have mercy upon us. Forgive us, O Lord. Forgive us on all that we have done wrong, all that we have done that have not pleased in his sight, in his way, our disobedience to his word. Let's begin to ask for his mercy. Let's begin to ask for forgiveness right now in the name of Jesus. Prayer.
The meditations of our hearts.
In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Right now, brethren, let's begin to soak ourselves with the precious blood of Jesus. Let's begin to sprinkle the blood of Jesus all over our environment, our gadget, whatsoever we are doing, whatsoever our family, our children, the bed, our beauty, our copper. Let's begin to sprinkle the blood of Jesus in the name of Jesus. Prayer.
The blood of Jesus.
Father, in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, Lord, I soak myself in the blood of Jesus Christ. I soak my children in the blood of Jesus Christ. Father, Lord, my God, I soak my home right now in the blood of Jesus Christ. My God, in the name of Jesus, I plead the blood of Jesus Christ. I plead the blood of Jesus Christ. I plead the blood of Jesus Christ. Father, Lord, my God, over our property, Lord Jesus. Everything be attending for me, oh Lord, my Father. Anything pertaining for me, my house, Lord, my God, I plead the blood of Jesus over our new home, Lord. I plead the blood of Jesus, my Father, Lord, my God. Let your blood, oh Lord, be to satisfy. Let your blood, oh Lord, be to flow. Shout to God, oh Lord, my Father. Let your blood be to destroy every works of darkness, oh God. In the name of Jesus Christ, every condition of darkness, oh my Lord, and my Father. Let your blood begin to destroy right now. In the name of Jesus Christ, my Father, Lord, my God. I plead the blood of Jesus Christ. I plead the blood of Jesus Christ over my home, over my marriage, over my life, over my children, over my mother, over my husband, Lord, for the remainder of this year, Lord. I plead the blood of Jesus Christ. I plead the blood of Jesus Christ. I head of worship for my Father into my tail, Lord, my Father. My Lord and my God, upon the floors, upon the windows, upon the roof, Lord, upon the chimney, upon our clothes, the water we drink, Lord, everything, my God, to Lord. I plead the blood of Jesus Christ in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Thank you for
in
your
Lord. Jesus' precious name we pray.
Mm. Amen.
Brethren, we are going to pray. Because you can see, as we are gathered right now, the children of God might be happy that we are gathered. But there is also the children of darkness who are not happy of our gathering. So right now, brethren, we are going to pray. Lord, any gathering that is not of you, that is gathered against our gathering this hour, any power that have been assigned against this gathering, any demonic agent that has been gathered against our gathering, against us this hour, oh God, let the consuming fire consume them right now in the name of Jesus. And let their Amen. Gathering never prosper nor stand in Jesus' name. Prayer.
Amen. My Lord and my Father, in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh Lord, my Father, Lord and my God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Every gathering of the powers of darkness, oh Lord Jesus, wherever they have gathered, Lord, concerning us, oh God. My Lord and my God, in the name of Jesus, wherever they have gathered concerning this prayer meeting, Father, concerning our life, concerning our children. My Lord and my God, let the fire Holy Ghost, be to Father, Lord, and my God, we call upon the fire of the Holy Ghost. My Lord, and my Father, let your fire go forth in the name of Jesus. Holy Ghost, be to scatter the Masona. Holy Ghost, be to scatter the Masona in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, Lord, and my God, every power shooting arrow against this prayer meeting, against us right now. Father, Lord, and my God, shooting arrows of scumber, shooting arrows of wickedness. We command the arrows to scatter by thunder. We command the arrows to scatter by thunder in the name of Jesus Christ. My Father, my Father, every arrow of darkness, fire that gets us right now, fire that gets us secret, fire that gets our household, fire that gets our family members, and to our Lord, my Lord and my God, we touch the arrow of scatter my thunder, wherever they have gone, my Father, we will let the fire of the Holy Ghost right now, into the covenant, fire of God begin to scatter them, fire of God begin to scatter them, in the name of Jesus Christ, in the name of Jesus Christ, my Father, Lord and my God, we will see them by fire, we will see them by fire, we will see them by fire, in the name of Jesus Christ, in the name of Jesus Christ, my Lord and my God, we release fire. 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 In the name of Jesus, we really fire. I really fire. Oh, thank you right now. In the name of Jesus, I really stop you.
In any garden, from the coven, from the principality of power.
Fire. Oh, Father, we command that to scatter in the name of Jesus. Wherever they have gathered to go, my Lord and my God, in the name of Jesus, we command the fire of God upon them right now. We release the fire of the Holy Ghost upon them right now. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. My Father, wherever they have joined us together, my Lord and my God, every gather up of the powers of that, every conspiracy, my Father, we cast them down. In the name of Jesus, the authority in the name of Jesus, we cast them down by fire. We cast them down by fire. Every power outside to put confusion, every power outside to shoot arrows on that, we command them to catch fire. We command them to catch fire. Arrows on that, catch fire. Arrows on that, catch fire. In the name of Jesus, Father, Lord and my God, every of their plan, every of their agenda, we scatter them by fire. In the name of Jesus, we decree.
In the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' precious name we pray.
Amen.
Amen.
Brethren, we're going to pray. Any power that has been assigned to stand against our testimony tonight, to stand against our blessings, to stand against our deliverance, every stubborn demon, every stubborn agent of darkness that have been assigned will say, okay, now you go there, you go and start. Block his blessings today. Block his deliverance. Let's begin to ask God. Wherever they are hiding, wherever they are, let the consuming fire swallow them up in the name of Jesus Christ. Prayer. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus.
My Father, Lord, and my God, in the name of Jesus, every stop of power. My Father, Lord, and my God, every power on our side of that testimony. My God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, let your fire swallow them up right now. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Fire of God, swallow them up right now. Every power, Lord, my Father, every agent of darkness, every power, which one powers, aside of Lord, against my testimony, aside of Lord, to throw my testimony into sorrow. I command them not to catch fire. My Lord, oh my God, in the name of Jesus Christ, I release the fire of the Holy Ghost against right now. I command them to catch fire. Agent of darkness, catch fire. In the name of Jesus Christ, my Lord, oh my God, let the fire of the Holy Ghost begin to swallow them up right now. Fire of God, swallow them up right now. Fire of God, swallow them up right now. In the name of Jesus Christ, Father, Lord, oh my God, wherever they are behind it, my Lord, oh my God, we release the fire. Fire of God, put them down. Put them down. Put them down. Put them down. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. My Father, wherever they planning, oh God, against my testimony, against my destiny, against my children, my Lord and my Father, I command the fire, I release the fire of the Holy Ghost, fire of God, swallow them right now, in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, let your fire, let your fire, let your fire, swallow them right now, in the name of Jesus Christ. My Lord and my God, wherever they are,
In the name of Jesus, in the mighty 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 name of Jes our finance, anything that is standing against our breakthrough. O God of Israel, let this scatter by fire and let our breakthrough begin to be open now in the name of Jesus. Let our finance begin to blow out in the name of Jesus. I pray.
Father, Lord, and my God, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. My Lord, and my God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, anything over my body, in dream, I break you. My Lord, and my God, every power standing, resisting my breakthrough, resisting my testimony. My Lord, and my God, Father, let your fire scatter them right now. We command them to scatter my fire. We command them to scatter my fire. I command my testimony to come from God.
Every kingdom of darkness that our name has been taken. Because when the name of the Christian is taken, anytime they are going higher in the fire of God, once their name is called there, they will be bringing down the fire of God. Once they are calling, making it a Christian, that Christian will be going down gradually. But we are going to pray this hour. We are going to ask God, oh God, my God, any altar, any kingdom of darkness that my name has been taken to bring me down, to pull me out of the foot. Oh God, destroy them by thunder of God in the name of Jesus. Let the fire of God be released upon that altar as we begin to pray right now. Prayer in the name of
Jesus. My God, in the name of Jesus Christ. My Lord, my God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, Lord, my God, any evil altar over my father, every demonic altar where my name has been taken to.
My Lord, my God, your holiness. Every demonic altar where my name has been taken to. My Lord, my God, your holiness. My Lord, my God, my Lord, my God, any evil altar. I'm taking my name. 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 I'm taking my name.
Jesus' precious name we have prayed.
Amen.
We are going to pray. We are going to ask God to terminate every covenant, every curse working against our life. It is terminated today, this night, in the name of Jesus. Ask God to terminate every covenant and curse working against our life. Against our family, let the Lord terminate the cycle in the name of Jesus.
My Father, Lord, and my God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, let every curse of God. Father, you say you have delivered me from the curse of the world. Oh Lord, my Father, every curse of Lord, every covenant oppressing in my life, oppressing in the life of my children, oppressing in the life of my husband, oppressing in my family, in the life of my mother. My Lord, Father God, in the name of Jesus Christ, let it be terminated. By the blood of Jesus Christ, be terminated by fire. Heavenly Father, King of glory, we give you thanks to praise your name, Lord. You are the God. No one like you, no before you, Lord. No one to be compared unto you. Father, we call upon your name this hour, O Lord. In your mercies, O God, in your kindness, O God, Father, give ear to our prayer. Answer our prayer, O Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, you say, call upon me in the days of trouble, you will deliver us, and we shall glorify your name. Father, we have to this hour, O Lord. Father, we thank you, O Lord, for asking prayer in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, King,
you, O Lord. We thank you, O Lord, for our testimony. Father, we thank you, O Lord, for our blessings. Father, we thank you, O Lord, for delivering us tonight in the name of Jesus Christ. We say thank you, O Lord. Be that exalted and be magnified. In Jesus' mighty name, pray. Amen. Hand over to you, Sister Maureen. God bless you.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
God bless you, brother, for that powerful prayer. God bless you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. So we call on our brother, Brother Godwin. Okay. He's not there. Okay. I think man of God is there. We call on our pastor.
Yeah, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
God bless you, sir.
Okay, praise Master.
Hallelujah.
Today is another night, and it's another day that the Lord has made.
Amen.
I hope we are ready to pray.
Amen.
Okay. There is power. There is power. There is power in the blood. There is power. There is power. There is power in the blood. There is power. Victorious power, there is power in the blood. There is power, there is power, there is power in the blood. There is power. Almighty power. There is power in the blood. There is power. There is power. There is power in the blood. There is power. Healing power. There is power. In the blood, there is power. There is power. There is power. In the blood, there is power. Victorious power. There is power. In the blood, there is power, there is power, there is power. In the blood, there is power, Jesus power, there is power. In the blood, there is power. There is power. There is power.
Question: where they do?
In the blood, there is power. There is power. There is power in his blood. There is power. There is power. There is power in the blood. There is power. There is power. There is power in his blood. There is power. There is power. There is power in the blood. In your troubles, there is power. In the blood of Jesus Christ, there is power, there is power, there is power in the blood of the Lord Jesus, there is power. In the blood, there is power. There is power. There is power in the blood. Oh, first and foremost, before we go to God in prayer, I want us to know there is great power. There is wonderful power. And there is sufficient power in the blood of Jesus Christ. And there is absolutely nothing the blood of Jesus cannot do. The blood of Jesus is so precious and is so powerful that every kingdom trembles when they see the blood. When they see a mark of the blood, every kingdom bows to the blood. They are fidgeting when they see the blood. They are in perplexity when they see the blood of Jesus. So as long as truly you have been redeemed, that blood is upon your life. If truly you have been saved, that blood is already upon your life. And once that blood is upon your life, my brothers and sisters, you are not an ordinary person. You're a very powerful Christian. That blood, just a drop of that blood in your life, is able to cause a great spiritual earthquake. And I know tonight there will be a great spiritual earthquake in your life to destroy the works of darkness, in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. I know there will be a great spiritual earthquake that will tumble the works of the enemy over your life.
Amen.
That the Holy Spirit will restore all those things that the enemy is trying to steal away from the children of God. But I want you to understand this power behind the blood, this wonderful power behind the blood of Jesus Christ. The blood is like a mystery, because you ask yourself, how is it that a liquid substance will be able to do so much? But the Bible has said something, that there is life in that blood. There is great life in that blood. And it's not just an ordinary life. It's a life that has internal fire, the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. I know that that blood is going to have its way in our life in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
We are going to be basically centering our prayers today. We are in just last days. We are in the last days to the end of the year. And there are a whole lot of things happening. You know what? I was moving. I wanted to get something. I've been trying to get an accurate Wi-Fi. And I see that people are too busy. It's not just over there. Everywhere is busy. So I don't know if it's because of the season. But with the level of busyness I saw outside when I went, I'm not talking of your place now. I'm even talking of in Nigeria, yeah, much more of other places. With the level of business, I was asking myself, you know, how are these people going to serve God? Because the level of business I saw, or I don't know how to put it, the level of walking around I saw, you'll be asking yourself, how are these people going to have time for the Lord? How are these people going to have time to pray? It's just all about business and making more money. But these are the spirit of the last days. And that's why the enemy is easily working against our lives. And it's easily working against our families. And it's easily working because it's not, I don't know if Satan is even as busy as, you know, the earth is like. Because during these last days of the month or last days of the year, people are just running helter-skelter and they are trying to make means. They don't know that, you see, this thing people call Christmas is even taking them gradually away from the Lord. And so that's why we're going to make some kind of prayers so that we'll call on the name of the Lord to destroy every evil plan of the enemy. Next year is going to be a year of prayer, whether Satan likes it or not. That's going to be one of our strong themes for next year. Because the 2018 prophecy is basically for the church. Just basically for the church. And the plan of the enemy towards the church. So for us, it's going to be a year of prayer. For some people, it's a year of prosperity. For some other people, it's a year of grace or something. For some other people, it's a year of holiness, and it's not wrong. But for us, it's going to be a year of prayer. My year of prayer. Our year of prayer. And I know that it's going to be reality in our life in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Mm-hmm. I hope we like that thing. Okay. Well, I hope so. I hope all of us will like that theme. It's a year of prayer. The first prayer point, you know, we'll pray right now is first. Before that, I welcome the Holy Spirit in our midst. And he's always been there with us. I welcome him properly and I say he should take his place. We'll pray right now to destroy every evil cloud around us right now. We'll command it to get away. I believe that there are some people at sleep right now and the enemy is trying to hold them down. And we're going to pray and release and destroy every evil cloud around us right now. Then that will give us the efficiency to go deeper in prayers. But we are not ignorant of the devices of the wicked one. So right now, wherever you are, you begin to talk to the Lord. You begin to talk to the Lord right now. Every evil cloud that is not of the glory of God, every evil cloud that is trying to revolve around our garden, to come and fire and brimstone, my father, my God, we command you to scatter by fire.
scatter right now. Go scatter right now. We release the fire of the Holy Ghost right now. Father, Lord, my God, in the name of Jesus Christ, we release fire. We release fire. We release fire. Fire and brutal in the name of Jesus Christ. Every evil cloud of God, from me, Lord, my Father, I take up my prayer. My Father, Lord, my God, every cloud of weakness, every cloud of slumber, in the name of Jesus Christ, we command us to scatter by fire, my God. We command us to scatter by fire, my God. We command us to scatter by fire, my God. Every cloud of darkness, Lord, my Father, coming over us now, coming over our houses. My Father, Lord, my God, in the name of Jesus Christ, I command us to scatter. I command us to scatter. I release the fire. Holy Ghost fire. Holy Ghost fire. Holy Ghost fire. Scatter them right now.
In the mighty name of Jesus. There are evil clouds.
You can off your own device. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
All this sitting down to be praying. Like very soon we'll soon stop this enjoyment and sitting down and praying, you know. But it's still more of enjoyment because you know, so there's some prayer points that we need to get very angry in your spirit with the enemy so that you can pray by the special grace of God. Because I was also waking up from sleep like you also. So I was, even though I didn't get enough time on the bed. Okay, come in. Okay, so right now we're going to continue. There are evil clouds. There are powers that are trying to stand in the way and are trying to cloud our meetings by the special grace of God. So that's why I said that we're going to release the fire of God it's not what we are doing there, and that's why by the special grace of God, if you're able to stand up, I'm trying to say lead by example.
Sister Jackson, stand up, you're the prayer warrior.
So if we can stand up and pray, let's stand up and pray. I think it's better that way than sitting down. So if you're sitting down, you'll be, it's like you're trying to enjoy yourself, like Sister Temi also, and Sister Cushion. So let's do all those standing up also, because soon you'll be releasing some fire. And you know, Sister Sandra, what kind of enjoyment is that? And look at Sister Pascaline and Sister Sarah and Sister Mercy, just all of us, and Sister Jackie, and okay, you know, Sister Joy must have stood up, and Sister Christiana, and Bro Sunday, I hope you are not sitting down. How can a man be sitting down? No, even if the women are sitting down, the Bible says they are weaker vessels. And Sister Murray, how can she be sitting down? And how can Joy be sitting down? And Bro Chido, your brother, your man, how can you be sitting down? And so let's do well, so stand up. Okay, I don't know if I should say Sister Rita can sit down, but if she can stand up, she can stand up. And so let's do that. And
I pray
that God will help us in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. There is power in the blood.
There is power, victorious power, there is power in the blood.
So right now you begin to release fire. There are evil clouds that we need to break, people. Those evil clouds, they are gathered even before our meeting. So right now you begin to pray. Every evil cloud gathering against the gathering of the children of God. I will never forget. I command them to catch fire. I release the fire. Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost, my Lord and my Father. I write to God, begin to do your work. I write, Lord, begin to do your work. Let your fire begin to burn. Holy Ghost, begin to fire. Holy Ghost, begin to burn. Begin to fire right now. Holy Ghost, begin to fire. Put them down the fire. Put them down the fire. In the name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus.
There are evil satellites. Evil satellite that has been sent to monitor every spiritual gathering. And these evil satellites will want to break them, will scatter them, get away from that place. These evil satellites, they are being sent by satanic agents to monitor every gathering. It's just like the way you have CCTV cameras. These CCTV cameras are responsible for watching. That's why right now we want to scatter them wherever they have gathered, even if they are here right now. Right now, let the fire of God begin to scatter them. Okay, in Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
I think also we'll try as much as possible if you can put your speaker on a loudspeaker so that whenever I say in Jesus' name, you are able to catch up by the special grace of God. You are able to catch up and so that we can continue with the next prayer point. One of the wicked evil spirits that I know that Satan uses against the children of God is the spirit of heaviness. Is the spirit of heaviness. See, one of the things that Satan hardly can try is that he doesn't dare try a child of God with spiritual sight. If there's a gift you should ask from the Lord, ask him to give you spiritual sight. Spiritual sight, because he knows that even if he was making a strategic plan against the children of God, they will know. So, but that's by the way, we'll still make a prayer point on that. But basically, the spirit of heaviness. Have you ever felt this heaviness inside of you like this? To pray. You can't pray. As in, the thing will so much overwhelm you. Even to say Jesus, you can't say Jesus. It's like you are even, it's like a demon spirit Because even the demon is afraid, doesn't want you to pronounce the name. So the demon doesn't want you to do anything called prayer. You are just so heavy. You are too heavy in your spirit. You can't understand it anymore. So it's a wicked spirit. I don't know. Have you felt like that before? Have you felt like that before? Whereby you are too heavy inside of your spirit. And with that, you cannot do any spiritual thing. You find it hard to do some certain things. It's a wicked, evil spirit we need to take away. You will not see that when that heaviness is taken away from you. There's this thing, you know, the enemy wanted me to be heavy just before I went to bed. I said, that's a lie. You can't stop me, you know. You can't put any heaviness, you can't put a load inside of me. You know, one thing I try to do is, I try to be happy, you know, to be joyful in my spirit. Because if I'm not joyful in my spirit, if I'm not happy, I can't preach a sermon. I can't preach, you know, I can't do some certain things, you know. I think that's what affects so many ministers. And, you know, if they are depressed in their spirit, maybe their wife just told them, I won't feed you today or so. Before you know it, he can't climb the pulpit. Even if he climbs the pulpit like this, his mind is thinking about what's happening around him, you know. So, but it is spirit of heaviness inside of you. Right now, you begin to release a fire. This fire is like a sledgehammer. So break that spirit of heaviness from your life.
In
Jesus Christ's name, we pray.
Amen.
And the kind of poverty you will be going through, you know that you are caused. You know understand what I'm trying to say. But then the kind of poverty you will be going through, you know that you are just caused. It's like it's a cause. You know why I say it's a cause? It's a spirit. I'm taking it to also something like a testimony or so, or it's also a of a satanic. I was talking about this. You know, some people think that we're called to be poor. Let's be poor and get to heaven. Let's be poor so that we can get to heaven. You know, some people have that mentality. and they don't know they are dealing with spirits. See, because it's not in the new covenant. Have you ever seen that in the new covenant? You know, in the new covenant, where it says that, you know, when he talks about poverty, he's not talking about, he's talking about poverty of spirit. Some people that they, because they want to be too spiritual, they have transformed it to, yes, I must be very poor, and that's the only way I can get to heaven. I hope somebody does not have that same mentality. Does somebody have that same mentality? Well, if you have that same mentality, no problem. I can leave you with that, you know, and you can continue with that, and you get to heaven. I will still get to heaven, and all of us will still meet in heaven by the grace of God. But I'm telling you the truth. It's a spirit, and it's a curse. There are in some families that there are evil covenants they have made. If you like, carry all the certificates you want to carry. If you like, study in the number of places you want to study. There will never be a progress in that place. These are some strategic plans of the kingdom of darkness. They know what they are doing. They know that if those things are not there, before you know it, you will go and sort out for some powers. Before you know it, you will go and make inquiry from familiar spirits. Before you know it, it will lead you to a whole lot of things that you don't want to do. Sometimes it's a curse. And these things are moving in different families. And these things are moving in different places. That's why we want to pray. Every spirit of poverty. You repeat after me. Every spirit of poverty.
Every spirit of poverty.
You don't understand. Spirit. That's why I don't know. Some people have this mentality, but I didn't carry that kind of mentality. I don't believe that it's not the location of place where you stay that makes you progress. It's the hand of God, and it's the grace of God. You know, some people have this belief that spirits, demons don't know location. If you like, stay in the sea. If you like, stay in the air. If you like, stay in the water. They don't know. That's not their business. Covenant can pass through different means. Covenant is not like, because of I'm in this. I want you to see somebody that is far away, you know. Maybe it's in South Korea. And the demon spirit that was disturbing his father did not still wait and still traveled all the way. He still took a flight with him, you know, when he was traveling, you know, on the air. He still went that way to South Korea, you see. All these things, they don't have limitations. Spirit don't have limitations. Spirit are not like human beings. They're not like flesh and blood. They don't have limitations. They can go everywhere. And these things are weaker spirits. That's why you really begin to talk to the Lord. Every evil spirit of poverty.
Every evil spirit of poverty.
Against my family. I call my family. I command you to fire.
name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. We consume right now. We consume right now. We consume right now. Spirit of poverty. Consume by fire. Spirit of poverty. We consume by fire. We must have by fire. We must have by fire. We must have by fire. For poverty. For the poverty.
In the name of Jesus. No matter how much you think you earn, the devil will still do it in such a way that you will still be on debt. And there are people here like that. You watch it, no matter how much you get in a month, you still fall into debt. It's a spirit. Can you imagine Jesus falling into debt? I can just imagine Jesus. Imagine Jesus like that. It's a spirit. Why? He doesn't want you to ever be satisfied with what you have. He doesn't want that. Instead, he wants you to run into problems. He said, is it not a big shame? There are some problems a Christian will go through. You might say this thing is not right. It's not normal. Something is just wrong somewhere. Something is just wrong. There are powers that want to eat from your pockets. And there are powers that stand and start eating from your pockets. But they start eating from your pockets in the realms of spirit. It doesn't work. It's not a physical thing. It's in the realms of spirit. They are already picking from you. Before you know it, it will manifest in the physical. We want to destroy every power eating and draining down your pockets. Every wicked power putting a hole in your pocket, putting a hole in any part of your body. Begin to come with them right now. Begin
to come with them. Oh Lord, putting a hole in my pocket.
Fire, Amen.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ, an evil pattern.
The devil is like a cycle. The devil wants to always allow in the life of the children of God. Every evil cycle. Maybe it's a cycle that from father to mother is trying to move in your life. It's something that your mother went through, and the devil says, I will pass it on to you. I will pass it on to this generation. From father to mother, from father to children. It's not the power of the new covenant. It's the new covenant. Every covenant. From every
Right now we'll pray.
Who talk to the Lord right now? Who talk? See, we are almost going to the end. How many days now? This 23rd or something like that. How many days do we have? It's less than maybe a week or something like that. A few days we have to the new year. Some people enter the new year in sorrow. Have you seen that? It was a new year. See that somebody, I've forgotten, I don't want to exaggerate, but somebody, see that he lost his father or mother, or he lost somebody dear to him or so. I see people enter New Year's like that. That first day of the year, that's when the devil decides to take somebody in their household. Like, see the first day, you just, it's a bad omen. The first day of the year, and what you receive is a bad news. You don't understand that it has a spiritual implication. It has a spiritual implication that if you are not careful, it's that same news you'll be getting. That's why we always have the crossover night. So that as you are grafting from 2017 to 2018, you are entering in prayer.
Yes.
Like in rain, the crossover night we are going to be doing. We are going to be praying. We are going to be praying for hours. As you enter into another 2018, it's a good omen. It shows that you are going to enter into that year in prayer.
Amen.
And you are not committing all things into the hands of the Lord. Think.
Amen.
No year return back. 2016 cannot return back again. I hope you know.
Yes.
That's another mystery we cannot understand. No year returns back. The year that Jesus lived on earth, he does not return back again. The year that something Moses lived on earth, it keeps on moving forward till the appointed time when the earth will be crushed off, till the appointed time when the earth will be destroyed and everything will go, and a new heaven and a new earth will be perfectly created. Everything. But you know the good thing, it is good when it's bad. So the plan of the enemy right now, even as I'm speaking, is that some people will enter 2018 in sorrow. The plan of the enemy is some people will enter this 2018 in tears. Why must it be that during the new year, and you are mourning? Listen to me, it's not normal. Some certain things, when you see it, you know it's not normal. You don't need a prophet to tell you that this is not normal. It's not the way it's supposed to be. You are entering into a new year, and you are entering into that year in sickness. Why can't you enter into that year? Let me tell you one thing that God has done for me. I know it happened almost 2 years consecutive now. I realize that every new year, something special happens to me. I don't know if it's a surprise or something. Within the first week of the new year, I'll just get something like maybe a major breakthrough. Also, I'll be asking myself, wow, I'll be so happy. And I know that it's the Lord doing this thing. It has happened almost 2 times now in a row. Also, that's the same way, a child of God, that's the same way it's supposed to be. Not in a new year. And you are saying, oh, my this thing had an accident. Don't you know those things have been planned by the enemy? He wants to put the children of God in reproach. He wants to put the church of God in reproach. He wants people to begin to talk and say, where is your God? so that they can speak against your God. So that they can talk against your God. So that they can pull down the power of your God. Listen to me. That's the plan of the enemy. So that people can say, where is your God? Where is this? Where is that? You know, I was just coming back from the bus. I said to myself, I was like, this Lagos I came to is like this Lagos. All the buses are mentioned. It's too quiet. So why is everybody quiet? Like, I preach gospel now. Why is everybody quiet? And one thing I realized is different from, I've always been in the East. But it's different from the East because the East, you don't find Muslims there. Jesus is the only way. In my mind, I'll say, any Muslim, if you want to slap me, no problem. But I'll tell you that simple truth, because everywhere was too quiet. Why must everywhere be quiet in the world? Why must everywhere be quiet in the world? It is there now. You see the way they will do their own radical evangelism in Muslims. You see the way they will do it, they won't even care. They won't even care. They can even do their, you know, put their hijab, do their washing of feet, even inside of the bus. Why would everywhere do this thing? And the funny thing is that some Christians are not wise. They will just keep their mouth shut. They see their fellow brother preaching the gospel. Well, it doesn't matter. I will raise up my voice like this. Preach the gospel. He gets so that because everybody are overtaken by one kind of celebration. I don't know. I don't know where it came from, you know. Preach the gospel. Let people hear the word. If they don't want to hear, and you know what I always do? Inside that bus, I pray to the Lord, give me a prophetic word. Give me a word of knowledge for somebody in this bus. Give me a word of knowledge so that they will believe in what I'm saying, you know. So you don't have to wait for you don't have to be on a pulpit to preach or something like that. Anywhere. If you see the place is silent, start it up in the train. If you see silence, start it up. Maybe if God even helps you on the airplane, if you see the place is silent, start it up. You know, maybe it's the pastor, like you were just there, you know, just start it up and start preaching. I hope they will not send you back, but they will say, get out of this airplane, you know. But you did radically around the earth, and you see God giving you the grace. That's the kind of fire we must carry in rapture at the end time moment. In the bus, wherever you are staying, in the car, wherever, even if it's in the airplane, you can try that. I don't know if they try that. But you can try that also, but you can try that to see if they'll be able to allow you to do that. Let's do that. That's the radical fire, you know. Listen, so we'll pray right now. Every wicked power that wants you to start the new year in sorrow.
I'm going to go to my father. Amen.
You don't want to be a true child of God. You'll be pitying the people of the world. You should be pitying the people of the world. You know why? They don't have the same covering that you have spiritually. And that's why Satan touches your family. And that's why he touches your brothers and sisters. Why doesn't he touch you sometimes? They don't have what you have. You have fire, they don't have fire. So that's why many of them are celebrating, you know, maybe the festival or whatsoever they call it or something like that. They might not have a perfect understanding, and the enemy can use that to work against their life. Before you know it, this is happening there, this is happening there. That's why God gave you his spirit. That's why God gave you his power. That's why God made you born again. And that's why he filled you with the Holy Ghost. And that's why he anointed you, so that there will be a remnant in your household. And so that even if your husband was not saved, even if your mother, your parents were not saved, even if nobody was saved, but because of you in that place, he put you as a watchman. As a watchman in that place. And so that you can bark at the dogs. But you know sometimes what the Bible says? It says, but their watchmen are dumb also. And they come back at the adversary. And that's why you are going to be praying and be speaking for your family. For those your brothers, for those your sisters, if it is not well with them, it will affect you, whether you like it or not. Because they will call you. They will distress you. Send me this. Send me that. Send me this. Send me that. You will be spending money all around. If it is well with them, it's a plus to you. It releases you from stress. It's many of the problems some people are going right now. It's not even as if it's their own problem. It's the problem of their own family. And you see how Satan is working. You are on your own. You just be your own. And the devil comes and he begins to bother some people. And the thing now comes to you. So you see, now Satan knows it's a strategy in the kingdom of darkness. And that's why when my mom was very sick, I knew that this thing was the arrow of darkness. Also, because it was really affecting me. And I was like, God, what's this? You know, I had to travel down just to ensure, you know, she's all right. But I got to realize that he knows. If he sees that he can't touch you, he's going to go meet them. And now, but if you can stand with them in prayer, if you can stand with them in prayer, you see that even when the devil wants to touch them, you begin to see fire. And the angel or the demons will say, look at, you can't touch him. Oh, look at that her mother, or look at that her brother, look at her, she's praying the rapture at the end of the moment. And you see that prayer they are making the rapture at the end of the moment. It's stopping us from touching them. There's a point in time I was listening to something, and the devil wanted to touch a particular lady. I think it was because of somebody was praying for her. So the devil thought that this one is like any other child that I can touch. You see, even your children. That's what we say, bring your children. Bring them up. Train them up in the way of prayer. Train them up to have fire. It's not only you that want to go to heaven. Them too, they have a soul. They have a spirit and they have a body of their own. They need to get to heaven. That's why God gave you to get those children to you. He wants you to bring them up in the right way. To bring them up in that way of fire. So that they will not depart away from it. And somebody can say, If not for that, my mother, you might think that you are not doing wicked thing to them. Yes, do it to them right now. I used to tell people that even though I had my mom dead, you know, it was as bad as it entered in my spirit. That was how they trained me, you know. It was as bad as, you know, young children nowadays. When I look at them, I laugh. My mom, you know, you're going to be watching. I'm so tired. I'm asking myself, what kind of person is this? You know? And you're going to be watching something like a TV screen. Maybe they are doing a movie. If my mom sees a boy and a girl just coming together, like, she'll wear off it from the switch. I said, what kind of person is this? Why she started like this? Why is she doing this? Sometimes I'm asking myself, you know, did she get married or something like that? Also, but you know, sometimes people that are aged, they have this high mentality of morality. Also, and that's how she'll do it. She'll go to the switch and go off it. Or I'll just be like, why is she behaving like this? Or maybe she sees us using the BCD or the video CD or something like that. You know what my mom is going to do? She's going to go there and go and plug it off. She's doing that constantly. And I used to think that she does not like us. So you see, that's the same way. You might tell your children, come to the place of prayer, wake them up at night. Why? They say, this is my mommy. She's always disturbing me. Don't worry. Let them see. They will see it as disturbance right now. Let them grow up very well. When they meet challenges of life, they will remember that thing you have done for them. Mm-hmm. It's not the one you are pampering there and say, they are special. When the problem never comes, if problem comes, you understand what I'm trying to say. So when they grow up, they will say, thank God, they taught me, she taught me. Ah, then, that year, maybe 2016, 2017. Now, this is 2050. My mom used to wake me up. In one rapture ending program, they used to do them like that. Maybe then, you know, maybe by then, we must have spread across all the universe. So, they don't say, they used to do it like an online fellowship. Then, you know, my mom used to wake me up. She would be disturbing me. And I'll be sleeping. I want to go, yes, disturb them now. Disturb them now. Don't pamper them. Don't pamper them and say, no. These ones are this. If you pamper them, it's very risky. It's detrimental also. So the same way you are catching fire, let them catch fire with you. The same way you are boiling, let them boil with you. They will not die. That thing you are thinking, they will not die. Prayer does not kill them. They will not die. The one that will even kill them is worst. Also, not this one. This one is a spiritual activity. So let that in your spirit. So that's why we want to pray. You know, as I was saying, then the devil came and he wanted to touch that one. So something happened. All of a sudden, it's like something like they wanted to strike the person through a mirror, and they saw that it was not working. And they were like, what is happening? The Holy Ghost is very funny also. The Holy Ghost transformed this small baby or this small district in a place. As in, like, transformed, it's like the Holy Ghost entered for the person. And the thing confused the kingdom of darkness. They cannot understand. See, you don't understand what the Holy Ghost is doing for you. You don't understand how the Holy Ghost is working for you at night. Sometimes there was an accident on the road, and the Holy Spirit will step in there and say, you cannot talk, but he keeps silent. Yeah. He will just be here watching me. He's just looking at me right now. He's just there watching me. He keeps silent. Very silent spirit. He's not there to take any glory and say, come and glorify me, you know. I'm the Lord in the Trinity. You know, I'm the King of all glory. No, a very gentle spirit. The Holy Ghost is doing so many things for us you cannot see. You know, maybe in your office, they said we are going to pull down 12 staffs in the office. And the Holy Ghost went there to whisper into the boss of the MD. Don't touch my daughter. She's a rare member. Don't touch my son. He's a rare member. The Holy Ghost just steps back. And they didn't reject. Now you say, it was because I was working too hard in this company. You don't know that the Holy Ghost is working for you. By the road, there was an accident that you are supposed to have that would have crushed you. But you know what? The Holy Ghost fast forward 10 times, or you retrogress the time because of you, which means the time was moving very fast. The Holy Ghost made your movement to be very slow so that you don't meet up. Are you seeing how God is working for you? They were coming with an arrow. They said, we will kill your daughter with convulsion. And they came with convulsion. Your daughter was convulsing. When she was having the convulsion, you thought it was ordinary. They wanted to kill her. The Holy Ghost said, no, you can't touch her. Look at her mother. Her mother is very prayerful. You can't touch her. And the Holy Ghost talked to those demons. Demons, get away from here. We don't understand it. But when we get to heaven, we understand it. We don't understand what the Holy Spirit is doing for us. Plenty things is doing for us. Plenty, 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 plenty things. things. You cannot imagine it. He's doing for you every day. That time you were supposed to lose it. Maybe about this year, you know, there was a time you were losing your breath. Everything was going out of you. You know, you are just dying. You know, you were seeing death, face to face with death. Holy Ghost said, no, my son cannot go this time. I've been there before. I said, no, it's not time for him to go. It's not time. He still has plenty of work to do. It's not time. Listen to me. The Holy Spirit is working day and night for the children of God. The Holy Spirit is fighting battles day and night for the children of God.
Amen.
But you know what? But you know what? We think it's by our effort. That's the self-righteousness I'm talking about. We think it's because we did this. But the Holy Ghost is just there. Like, he's just there laughing and smiling. And he's just there saying, they don't understand. Maybe when they get to heaven, they will understand me better. He's the powerful one. When you die, he will escort you. And he will take you to the heavenly world. The Holy Ghost is doing so many things. So many things for us. There are times, you know, I'll just see a hand. A hand will tap me. Chidozie, wake up. Who is calling me? Who is calling Chidozie? Chidozie, wake up. And I don't know that there is an attack waiting for me. Then I remember that somebody was waiting. You don't understand. I'm talking like physical hand touching your body. Wake up. Wake up. Wake up. Wake up. And you know, I'll be like, but I'm tired though. I just said, that's how powerful the Holy Ghost is. Can you imagine all the things he's doing for you? You were having a particular attack in your dream, in the dream world. They came mightily to pull you down. But the Holy Ghost stood there. They consulted your name through a mirror. They called your name three times. You did not appear. Holy Spirit appeared for you and stood there like this. I say, you can't touch her. And they say, this gossiper, you have come again. You have come again. Because they call him a great gossiper. They say, this gossiper, you have come again. What are you doing here again? And the mirror just scatters like that. Case over. Case finished. And you see, they can't touch you. Can't you understand? But the people of the world don't have that power. The Holy Ghost will not stand like that for somebody that is not washed by the blood. The Holy Spirit does not stand like that. For somebody that is not purified by the blood, the Holy Spirit will not stand like that. He only stands for the children of God. The children of God. He's called the angel of the presence. Or Michael the Great One. He stands for the children of God in battle. He's been deployed for the armies of Jesus Christ. We'll pray again for our families wherever they are. Possibly because of the fire in you. The fire might begin to touch them and reach them because of you. Not because of them, but because there is somebody that has Jesus in that place. You begin to pray, every arrow of the enemy, I'm Right now, we want to pray for Rapture Radio Time Movement. We want to pray for everybody in the fellowship. We want to pray for any wicked power that wants to touch any one of our members. Any wicked power that wants to touch their life. Any wicked power that wants to put them to shame. Any wicked power that wants to attack them. Even if the attack is taking place, begin to scatter them right now. We pray for all the things we intend to do, all our plans for next year, even all our plans. We'll pray for the revival meeting, the prayer meeting tomorrow by 1 p.m. We're going to pray for it. We're going to pray for the outpouring of the Spirit of God. We're going to pray right now that whatsoever we're going to do in that revival meeting and our December retreat that starts on Sunday, we're going to pray that whatsoever we're going to do, that let the power of the Holy Ghost take charge.
My Father, Lord, and my God, in the name of Jesus.
Another prayer point also that we want to make also is for everything that we are trying to do, all the evangelism outreach that we are trying to plan, all the plans that we have made, you know, that let the fire of God, even the campground that we want to get. We want to pray also that everything that we are trying to do, that let the Lord begin to have his way.
My God,
my rock of ages, O Lord, let your name be glorified in everything that we do. In the name of Jesus, we pray, amen.
Many people have determined in their hearts to also contribute towards the on-ground campground. But the enemy himself might want to withhold the abundance of some people. And that's why we want to pray that let the Holy Spirit begin to release. This is the work of the Holy Spirit. It's the power of the Holy Spirit. It's the assignment of the Holy Spirit. It's not my assignment. Jesus cannot go there and go and be fighting some battles. That's the work of the Holy Spirit. That's what the Holy Spirit can do. And so right now we want to pray. We want to pray right now that wherever all those things that the enemy has taken from the children of God, every of our abundance, that the enemy is trying to steal away from us, maybe so that maybe some of us have made the vows. Some of us have told the Lord when we said that this is what I will give. This is what I will give towards this. But you know, the devil is trying to steal from them. He's trying to take from them. He's trying to do some certain things. That is why right now we will begin to pray. We will begin to pray that wherever the enemy has tied down the abundance of the children of God, I say, let there be a release. Let there be a release of abundance. I think I'm having a leading in my spirit to pray for everyone here for abundance. Raise up your hands. If you want the Holy Spirit to surprise you. Now, if there was something that somebody was owing you, is going to be paid. If there was, you know, I've not made prayers like this before, and if there was something that has been held away from you, maybe it's something about that has to do with your salary, it's going to be paid to you, it's going to be given to you. Also, wherever you are, also there are some particular persons, because I'm going to release the angels of abundance. They are going to go around now and they are going to open the doors that are closed. If there was a closed door in the area of your abundance, your financial need, it's going to be opened by the special grace of God. And whatsoever, I'm talking whatsoever treasure that Satan has stolen away from you. Why am I making this prayer? Because I get to realize that Satan can also steal from the children of God so that the work of God will not move forward. It's a strategy of the kingdom of darkness. Some of you say you need a house and you want this house. Don't worry, you are going to get it in the name of Jesus Christ. If there was something that you are asking of the Lord that has to do with your need, that has to do with your need, your physical need. We are not in heaven yet. We are still on earth. We are not in heaven yet. If we are in heaven, we will not need all those things. It is on earth you need all those things. When you get to heaven, you don't need all those things, you know. So we are on earth here. All those things that you need. Begin to raise up your hand right now. And I'm going to make a declaration. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Oh Lord, are there things that the enemy is stealing from your children, and it rightfully belongs to them? I release the angel of blessing.
Amen.
I release the angel of abundance.
Amen.
Let him go for there and open the doors for your children in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And people are owing them and refusing to pay. Oh Lord, they are going to be getting some divine calls.
Amen.
They are going to be getting some strategic calls.
Amen.
Because every door that is standing in the way, that door is broken in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, wherever you're children are right now. I begin to release the angel of abundance upon their life, Lord. Although we are not saying this thing so that we will use it maybe for only ourselves. We are saying so that it's going to be beneficial to the work of the living God. Oh Lord, is there something that the devil has hidden from them? Is there something that the devil has strategically collected from them and it rightfully belongs to them? Is there a right that rightfully belongs to them and the government is hiding that thing from them right now? Is there a commission that the devil is rightfully taking away from them? I say I release it right now.
Amen.
I say it right now. Amen. Because the angel of the church is here and the anointing breaketh every yoke. Oh Lord God Almighty, I stand, oh Lord, as in the shepherd of this ministry. Oh Lord God Almighty, and I use my authority. King of all glory, I say, let it be released unto your children.
Amen.
Oh Lord, you allow every declaration and miracles to take place, not because of my worthiness, but because of the worthiness of Jesus. Not because of my righteousness, but because of the righteousness of Jesus. Not because of my holiness, but because of the holiness of Jesus. Not because of my truth, but because of the truth of Jesus. Oh Lord God Almighty, by the power behind the cross, and by the power in the name of Jesus, I say, let there be a release right now.
Amen.
Jesus Christ, Lord, I have some of them here, and the devil is cheating them. He's cheating them. Somebody is stealing your money. You were supposed to get a particular amount of money, and one woman comes here and she digs into it and she tries to reduce it away from you, and they are cheating you. I say that must stop right now.
Amen.
Jesus Christ, Lord, wherever your children are right now, Lord, I say let there be overflow.
Amen.
Let there be overflow. Amen. Because you said in Psalm 1, whatsoever that man doeth, he shall prosper.
Yes.
That anything he's doing, he will prosper. Because he's a child of God. He's one that has the Spirit of God. He's one that is journeying to heaven. So he's not overtaken and he's not carried away by the riches of this world. But he understands that every riches that he has belongs to the Lord. Oh Lord, whatever that man doeth, whatever that sister doeth, whatever that brother doeth in rapture again, my woman, he shall prosper in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Oh Lord, I don't care what they say. Even if they say that this thing is not like this, people are not making it, it's not my business. But because you have the blood of Jesus, imagine Jesus entering into a business and Jesus failing. Imagine Jesus working in a company and Jesus being retrenched. Imagine Jesus being sacked from a company. No, because he will say, this I want to use for my father's business. Right now, wherever you are, I say, let the door, the windows of heaven, let it be open unto you in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I release a blessing, not a curse.
Amen.
I release the blessings of God upon your life.
Amen.
I release the promise of God in your spirit.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus, amen. Every power from your village, every power from your foundation, they say you will not flourish. They say you will not prosper. And they have made an evil deal. They say if you like, travel all over the world, nothing will work out well for you. Now that is what the devil said. Listen to what the child of God says. Listen to what the servant of God says. I say right now, every curse in your life, with respect to your finances, I break that curse and I put a blessing in the name of Jesus Christ. Every evil day they have used to tie down. These things that God has given to the children of God. Right now, I begin to uproot it. In the name of Jesus, go and prosper.
Amen.
Go and be free.
Amen.
Go and
sustain
on every wicked spirit, every wicked power I track in your divine helpers. Go and meet your divine helpers out there.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus, I release the blessings of God upon your life. Go and meet with you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ, I release the blessings of God upon your life.
Amen.
Wherever you go, whatsoever you do, it that is in the word of God, it will surely prosper.
Amen.
There shall be no lack.
Amen.
There shall be no lack.
Amen.
There shall be no limitation.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Lord, God Almighty. And when Moses saw that this particular cloud was not increasing, and Moses released a blessing because of the curse Jacob had released upon his first son, and Moses released a blessing, and Daddy Lord, my God, that particular cloud was growing. Amen. Any country fellowship that is not growing, I command growth.
Amen.
That is not working well. I command it to work well right now. Amen. Jesus Christ, any part of your life that is retarded, I command you to receive life.
Amen.
Amen. That your son Amen. That is sick, I command you to upon his life.
Amen.
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 That is hot in the body, I command healing upon her life.
Amen. Amen.
Wherever you are, whatsoever that man doeth, he will prosper.
Amen.
And anyone that sees you will call you blessed.
Amen.
Because you are the head of the Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Jesus Christ,
Amen.
They see you, instead of you going to death to even borrow them, you will they will come to meet you and say, please
Amen.
Help me. And you will now preach the gospel. You will now tell them, you see, Jesus is good. You
Amen.
See, Jesus is God. You see, Jesus did it for me. So Jesus
Amen.
Can do it for you. So come
Amen.
Into your body and let's get to heaven together. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. And when they see the prosperity of God upon your life, they are going to say, what's the secret? What's the secret? How do you do it? And you are going to show them the way to the cross. And you're going to show them the way to heaven. And you're going to say, let's come together. I want to help you. But Jesus is calling you to heaven. And you know, they will listen to your voice. And after you know it, they will journey to heaven like you are journeying to heaven. That is the way God has designed. In the name of Jesus Christ. Every wicked power tormenting you. Tormenting your prosperity, tormenting your finances, tormenting your abundance, that doesn't want you to flourish. They say, I have put a stampede on you. They say, I have done this on you. In this spirit, I don't care who did it. Even if it was Satan that did it, I command it. Listen to me. Satan is their ogre. All these little witches and wizards, they are small children. They are learning war before Satan. And so they cannot touch a child of God. Because we wrestle not against flesh and blood, principalities and power. Not all these small witches. These ones are still little. The powers your uncles are using, they are still little. Right now, any wicked power I command it, scatter by thunder. Maybe they are saved. No matter what you do, you will not carry your baby. No matter what you do, you will not get married. Listen to me. 2018, there's going to be plenty of marriages. And as you turn into heaven, as you think about heaven, as you think about Jesus, as you do his work, the Holy Spirit is now going to be working for you.
Amen.
This is done in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
We can take our seats. Okay, I'm going to soon hand over to the coordinator. My joy is flowing. My joy is flowing like a river. My joy is flowing. My joy is flowing like a river. The reason for my joy. The reason for my joy is Jesus. My joy is flowing. My joy is flowing like a river. My joy is flowing. My joy is flowing like a river. My joy is flowing. My joy is flowing like a river. As we see Sandra sings. My joy is flowing. There is sin for my joy. There is sin for my joy. My joy is flowing. My joy is flowing like a river. We are blessed, and we are blessed in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Let's remember tomorrow is our prayer revival meeting. So let's invite our friends and our families. And we are just going to be like this, just like on a video. And we are going to be live on two strategic places. Possibly, we're going to be live on just direct on my profile. I'm going to be live on the REM also, Worldwide Ministry Facebook page also, just on Zoom and also, you know, direct, you know, so that we can share the message on YouTube and other people can also get it by the special grace of God. So let's invite our friends and family
And I know that the Holy Spirit will have his way in our life in the name of Jesus. Let's remember our December retreat. Our December retreat starts, you know, on Sunday. By the grace of God, the evening session we are going to have, I'm looking for how to bring down, some people are telling me to bring down the time, So maybe possibly, instead of 7 to 9, might be from 5 to 7, you know, to bring down the time so that if anybody wants to join us physically, they can go back home by the special grace of God to bring it out. So maybe I'm going to share the templates or something like that for the programs and the sermons. And we are going to have, by the special grace of God, also a beautiful movie to watch, you know, a Christian movie, a very wonderful movie that will teach us about the kingdom of God. Also, so it's going to be beautiful. So I know your children are going to enjoy that. By the grace of God, you know, hey, mommy, look at that woman, is that him? Look at that woman, you know, that's what they like, you know. So, and it's going to be highly innovative, and it's not just an ordinary movie. It's something that has to do with God's kingdom, you know. Even if we watch that, it's Christian. There are Christian movies by the grace of God. So let's prepare ourselves for that by God's grace, also. And for some of us, we know the things we wrote personally to the Lord. Also, let's try to do that because I'm going to have a little bit of meeting with some people and so that we do what we need to do to get the campground. No matter what we have, we're going to get that by the grace of God. Okay? I know that there are some persons that I've not called. I'm going to call them. So don't think that I've forgotten. You know yourself, that brother. Don't think that I've forgotten. I've not forgotten, you know. So, like I wrote to you, I'm going to do that. It's just that I've been filled with a lot of things somehow. Okay, so let's try. For some of us that are in the UK, some of us are not doing well. Please, let's try to always be in our meetings. Please, let's try. Don't worry, very much soon, we are going to have a prayer revival meeting for the UK fellowship by the grace of God. Okay. And I know God will help us. For all the coordinators, remember my report that I'm supposed to get either within 25th or before 25th. So, reports to me. I want to be seeing my report. Okay? I know that the Holy Spirit will help us and will bless us in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I don't know what the next Friday that we are going to enter, is it the last Friday? Is it going to be the last Friday of the month? Okay, is it going to be the last Friday? I don't even know if I'm going to be around because I want to make some travel. Today's 23rd. The last Friday, okay, which means it's going to be the last Friday of the month.
Yes.
I'm going to check. Okay, and Monday, is this Monday going to be the last Monday of the month also? Okay, so which means we are going to have another program this Monday, like we said, first and last, but I don't know. I'm going to let us know. Maybe because of the December retreat or so. I don't know. But whatsoever, I'm going to let us know. I know God will have his way in our life in the name of Jesus. I hand over to the coordinator, the person coordinating the fellowship. God bless you. Okay.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen. We bless God for this wonderful prayer, for this wonderful deliverance. Let us unmute and as we pray for man of God, let us pray that God should continue to empower him, incubate him with more fire in the mighty name of Jesus. Open your mouth and begin to pray for him.
Amen.
let us also pray for Brother Sunday that God should continue to incubate him with more fire upon his life in the mighty name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. We have come to the end of today's service.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Sorry, how would you say, I know there's one sister in our midst. Let's introduce her. Let's see. Sister Emela. Sister Emela, can you hear me? Can you unmute your mic? Press that unmute button so that you can speak. Sister Emela, she might not be coming. We can't hear you though. If you can press the unmute button, you'll be able to speak. Just to introduce yourself. Okay, even if she can't do it, I believe that she's. I believe that she's hearing us. Let's welcome Sister Emela. What do we say to Sister Emela?
Sister Emela, you are welcome in Jesus' name.
Okay, Emela, you're welcome in Jesus' name. And we love you. Just too well to join other programs. I believe I've sent some certain things to you by the grace of God. Okay. No problem. So can I continue?
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Mm-hmm. Hallelujah.
We call on Sister Patience to lead us in a monthly declaration. God bless you, ma'am.
Mm. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
This is my month of evangelism.
So
praise the word.
So praise the word.
To deliver the oppressed. With a great body of souls. So help me God. And the people of God says,
Amen. The grace in fellowship.
Many
grace of the Lord Jesus Christ. Love of God. In all the days of our lives, and we shall pray in the house of the Lord forever and forevermore. Amen. God bless you all. Shalom.
Shalom.